Today we will study linear system of ordinary differential equations. So firstly I am starting that linear system of ODE. So we consider n differential equations, ordinary differential equation in n unknowns. Okay, so before going their behavior and solution, I am taking few examples. So first is, so example where these equations originate or they describe some physical or biological processes. So I am taking a 2 by 2 system. This is known as Lotka, Volterra equation, and also it is known as predator, prey model. So we have, of course, we have two species denoted by X and Y. So X is the population of prey, or you can say this is food, and Y is the population of predator. For example, you can say that predator are foxes and prey are rabbits. So this 2 by 2 system looks like dx by dt. So this is the growth of population of prey. So population growth is proportional to itself, so this will be proportional to x. And if I remove this proportionality constant, so this is alpha x. So the prey population have an unlimited food supply at all times, and in the absence of predator, the prey population x would grow proportionality to its size. So dx by dt equal to alpha x. Alpha is a some positive number, and this alpha is called Volterra coefficient. Okay, so, and also population of predator, so in the absence of prey, so they don't have food, so their population will be declined, would decline proportionally to its size. So dy by dt, so they have, may have negative growth in the absence of food, or you can say prey. But and now of course we add some parameters. So and as predator eat the prey, so their population will be declined. Okay, so I am adding a factor. So this is a change in, okay, so change in prey numbers. So growth minus the rate at which it is preyed upon. So similarly, the predator equation will become minus. So since they are having food, so their population will be increased by this number delta xy. So here all alpha, beta, gamma, delta, they are positive constants. And of course now you have this system, so this is a 2 by 2 system. Okay, so you have two differential equation in two unknown x and y. So both x and y they are function of t. So t is an independent variable and x and y they are dependent on t. So to solve these problems you need to find x and y in term of t. And second example I am taking from famous LCR circuit. So you have a capacitor, okay, capacitor C, and then you have a resistance R, okay, and you have inductance L. So we have inductance L. So this is L R C circuit. So we consider a parallel L R C circuit as shown in this figure. So let V be the voltage. Let V be the voltage drop across the capacitor, and I is the current through the inductor. So then we can show that the voltage and current are described. So you can write two differential equations for current I and voltage. Current I and voltage V. So they satisfy the following differential equation. So di by dt equal to V by L and dV by dt is equal to minus I by C minus V by RC. So where L is the inductance, C capacitance, and R is the resistance. So this is famous. So this is the system of two differential equations in two unknown current and voltage, and both are function of T. So we have shown that these systems originate in application. They may be biological, physical, or electrical. So now we study these systems of an equation in an unknown. So now I am giving technical or mathematically, so how they originate. So we can develop this system. I am taking one more example. So also we can transform higher order equation. So let us say you have a second order equation x dash double dash, which is a function of t, x dash, y dash, y double dash, okay, and you have another equation. So y double triple dash is g t x dash y dash y double dash. So question is that rewrite. So this is again a system, but second you have d2x by dt square and d2y by dt square. So we don't have a first order system. Okay, so rewrite this system as a first order system. So technically you can make a system from higher order equations or higher order system. So we need to write it as first order system. So we treat or we regard unknown x, x dash, y dash as unknown function. As unknown functions and rename them. So let us say start from x. Say x is x1. Its first derivative say x2. Then y is y1. then first derivative of y is y2, then second derivative is y3. So these all unknown x1, x2, y1, y2, they satisfy the following system. So firstly, what you write x1 dash, okay? So that will be x dash. So x dash is x2. Okay, so now you write x2 dash will be, x2 dash means x double dash. So f double dash means you have the relation ft, x is x1, this is x2. Okay, let us write them y1, y2, and y3. Okay, then in y variable for y1 dash is just y2. Then y2 dash is y3 and y3 dash. So this is g t x1, x2, y1, y2, y3. So from this system of two equation of second and third order, you got a system of first order equations having five equation and five unknown. So in that way, you can write any higher order system into first order system. So next example, I'm showing that you can write a, so you can construct system for from scalar differential equation, scalar ODE. So this means that scalar means you have only one equation. Okay, so rewrite the equation. Let us say you have y4 derivative plus 4y third derivative plus 6y second derivative plus 4y derivative plus y equal to 0 as a 4 cross 4 system. Okay, so this is a fourth order differential equation. Okay, so we need to write it as system. So in the same manner, so we write, so start labeling, say y equal to y1, then y dash equal to y2, y double dash is y double dash is y3, and y triple dash, say this is y4. So we have y4, that is y third. So y4 dash plus 4y4 plus 6y3 plus 4y2 plus y1 equal to 0. Or you can write, so what is system now? You have first equation y1 dash equal to y2. Okay, so left on left hand side, right derivative. Okay, then y2 dash is y3, y3 dash is y4, and y4 dash is equal to minus 4y4 minus 6y3 minus 4y2 minus y1. So this is a system of, so this is a 4 by 4 system in 4 unknown y1, y2, y3 and y4. So in that way, mathematically you can form a system from higher order scalar equation, or you can make a system from higher order systems. So now I am going to write in it the system in matrix form. So matrix form of system. So this is a convenient way when you have a system of, let us say, a first order system is, a first order system can be written as, so let us say y is the variable, so y1 dash, I'm writing a11, which is a function of t y1 plus a12 y2 and a1n yn plus right hand side, F1T. Then you have second equation y2 dash equal to a21 coefficient y1 plus a22 y2, then a2n yn plus f2t and so on. So last equation you have yn dash equal to an1 y1 plus an2 y2 and ann yn plus fnt. So here also put t. So these coefficient may, so they are functions of t. So this is a linear system. Okay, so linear system in n unknowns. So what are unknowns? Y1, Y2, Yn, and all are function of variable t. So in matrix form I can write, in matrix form, so make a left hand side vector y1 y2 dash dot dot yn dash. Okay, column vector, then coefficient matrix. So a11, I am skipping t, so all are functions of t. So a11, a12, a1n. Okay, then a21, a22, a2n and so on, and last equation an1, an2, ann, then column vector y1, y2, yn plus non-homogeneous term f1, f2, fn. So in that way you can write the system into matrix form, or more compactly, so you can write y dash. So this is bold y dash. So y dash equal to a t y plus f of t. So what is y dash? So this is a column vector. Okay, so this is a column vector of derivative. So what is y? This is also a column vector, so containing y1, y2, yn, a coefficient matrix, and f is a right hand side non-homogeneous term. So we say that AT is the coefficient matrix, and FT, which is non-homogeneous part, this is called as forcing function or non-homogeneous term. So if A, so not if, so 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 A and F are said to be continuous, so they are matrix now, so are said to be continuous if each of the entry is continuous. So if entries are continuous, so matrix is continuous. So matrix or column vector, so both are continuous. So if f equal to 0, so we say system is homogeneous. And if f is non-zero, so we say that system is non-homogeneous. Also, you can define initial value problem for system. So initial value problem, IVP. So IVP is, so y dash equal to a t y plus f of t, and y at t naught is k. Okay, so k is again a column vector, so that make have k1, k2, kn, and all entries are now matrix. So in that way you can write an initial value problem like we rot for first order equations. And same existence theorem is valid here as well. So now I am just stating the existence theorem. So let coefficient matrix, so only continuity criteria is required. So let coefficient matrix A and function F are continuous on interval AB, and let T naught be any point in AB, and let K be an arbitrary constant column vector. Then the initial value problem y dash equal to a of t y plus f t with one condition y at t naught is k has a unique solution on interval a b. So this is the existence theorem for system, and proof is similar as we did for one dimension in proving of Picard's theorem. So now I am taking one example. So question is, first part of the question is that write the system. I have 2 by 2 y1 dash equal to y1 plus 2 y2 plus 2 e power 4 t, and y2 dash equal to 2 y1 plus y2 plus e power 4 t in matrix form. Okay, write system in matrix form and verify existence theorem. Okay, so you need to check continuity of matrix and right hand side vector. Second part is that verify that y equal to 1 by 5 8 7, this is column vector, e power 4 t plus c1 1 1 e power 3t plus c2 1 minus 1 e power minus t is a solution of the system. Third part, find solution of IVP. Okay, so now you have same problem, IVP with initial condition y0 1 by 5 3 and 22. Okay, so firstly write the system into matrix form. So you have system y1 dash equal to y1 plus 2 y2 plus 2, so y2 dash equal to 2 y1 plus y2 plus e power 4 t. So matrix form is, so left hand side derivative, right hand side coefficient matrix, so 1 y1 1 y1 2 y2 2 y1 y2. So coefficient of y1 y2 without t, so y1 y2, so if you multiply you got to right hand side, plus vector having only term t, so that is forcing function, so e power 4t. So this is the matrix form of the system. So to verify, so this is, you can write y dash equal to a y plus f. Okay. So since a is a constant matrix, so this is continuous, so a is continuous and f is also continuous. So this problem has a solution on R, so there is no problem, so everywhere they are continuous. So this problem has a solution, so that is the part A, existence. So in part 2 we will verify that this is a solution. So we will show that given function satisfy the equation. So now I need to compute a y plus f. Okay, so what is a? So a matrix A is 1 2 2 1, and from the solution y, so y is 1 by 5, so you can write 1 by 5 here, so no problem. So 1 by 5 column vector 8 by 7 e power 4t plus c1, okay, c1, then again multiply by y, so multiply a with y, that given y, and 1 1 e power 3t plus c2 1 2 2 1 1 minus 1 e power minus t plus f. F is 2, you can write f, so f is 2, so you can take e power 4t outside. Okay, so this is just 2 a e power 4t and e power 4t, you can take e power 4t outside, so this is f. So now multiply, so first matrix 1 by 5, so multiply both, so you got 22 23 e power 4t, then c1, so multiplication is 3 3 e, usual matrix multiplication, then c2 times minus 1 1 e power minus 3t, then forcing function 2 1 e power 4t. Okay, so now club everything. So you need to club first and last. Okay, so they are e power 4t, so take e power 4t outside, so you got 1 by 5 32 28 e power 4t plus 3 c1, you can take 3 outside, so write 1 1 here, e power 3t, you can take minus outside, so 1 minus 1 e power minus 3t. So this is ay plus f, right hand side, and you can check this is just y dash. Okay, so just differentiate that solution. So this y satisfy the equation, so it is a solution. And in part C you need to solve IVP. So to solve IVP we find constant C1 and C2 in part 2, C1 and C2. So 1 by 5, so 1 5, okay, sorry, 1 by 5, 1 by 5, solution 8 7 e power 4t plus C1 1 1 e power 3t 1 C111. So just fit t equal to 0, that is, so to solve IVP, so you need to take t equal to 0, so y at y at 0 is given, so C111 plus C21 minus 1, so just equal to 1/5 C22, so A Y plus F equal to Y of dash. And solution at t equal to 0, so this is given, t equal to 0, solution is given. So now solve for C1 and C2. So you can club everything here. So matrix is 1, 1, 1, minus 1, C1, C2. So this is also absent, so t equal to 0. So club this one with right hand side, okay, and keep C1 C2 on left hand side, so -1, 3, and solve for C1 and C2, so you got C1 equal to 1, C2 equal to -2, so solution Y is 1/5 e power 4t plus 1 e power 3t, C1 is 1 and C2 is -2, 1 minus 1 e power minus 3. So which is the unique solution of IVP? So in that way, to verify that certain function is a solution, you need to fit that y as we did in ordinary differential equation. And to find solution of IVP, you need to find C1 and C2 by using the given condition. So that was given that we know the solution at t equal to 0. And so you should not have any difficulty in the notation. So I am writing that. So let us say you have e power 4t 2 times. So I am writing it as, so 1, 2. So I'm taking e power 4t outside. Okay. So if you have like this 5, 25, okay, e power 3t, e power 3t, okay. So I'm writing it, you can take 5 outside. So this is also, you can take e power 3t outside. So this is 1 and 5. Okay. So you can write the matrix in that form. So you can take coefficient outside. And usually we write a function containing t, so that I am writing after the matrix, and constant term you can write before or after, that's your choice. So in that way we can obtain systems of equations, systems of ODE from higher order system, systems and scalar equations. And now in the next video lecture, we will solve the system, and for simplicity, we will take example of 2x2 and 3x3 system depending on the situation. And before that, we will recall the stuff from ODE, that Wronskian linear independence, etc., in next class.